Alright guys and girls, this is Bagofsoup coming at you with a pretty crazy match today, Showdown on Shenzhen. I have been messing around with my hangar recently with the new dashbot, with the Scourge weapon as well, and you know we haven't had our kids on lately, haven't had Bags of Riches. How are you, man?
Good.
And Cup of Soup?
Hey, we're almost fans!
And Sara Soup, how are you?
I'm doing good, I'm just a little... I just have allergies.
Oh,
hey guys,
okay.
I saw a Carnage Ansel's back there.
Yeah, we saw a Carnage with double Ansel's, and I didn't even think to stick with him because I already had an Ansel on my Dashbot Mark II here. So this is a fun match. I noticed the Beaconator's on the other side. He's a pretty tough opponent, but he's been dropping into long-range bots lately, and on a map like this, he's going to be kind of limited in how he uses it, so I felt like I could jump right into a beacon grabber and a high-powered bot. I am still using the Dashbot Mark II. I've got some recommendations for Pixonic on how to nerf or adjust the bot, hopefully with this coming next update. Who knows? Because it's still pretty strong. What do y'all think, boys and girls? What would y'all do to adjust the Dashbot?
I can't make it weaker.
Okay, make it a little weaker, Bag says. I think get rid of one of the two dashes would be the easiest thing right there. What do you think, Cup of Soup?
I was thinking, what if one of them, gets more skins? I think they should have more skins.
More skins would be nice, of course, but they're new. But right now, they're just strong. They're very, very strong, especially in the hands of a good player like, say, you know, moi. I'm pretty decent with them. But some guys out there are just averaging, you know, 800, 900,000, a million damage with these guys right now. And not everyone can get them in the black market. So hopefully that'll change with the next update. But I say take one of the dashes away and just leave one. And then maybe lose one medium weapon there and just put a light on there. Like the new glider bot has two mediums and a light. Something like that. But at least one dash would be huge. You can catch those guys out in the open with the pants down and be able to shoot them good. What is y'all's favorite dash bot? Mark 1, 2, or 3?
Definitely Mark 2.
You like the Mark 2 here? Yeah, the Haechi?
Yeah, because it has an Ansel.
Yeah, you like the Ansel shield on there. You're a big Ansel fan. I know that. What about you, Cup of Soup? Which one do you like best?
Dashbot 3.
You like the Mark 3 with the physical shield on there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would like that with some Scourges. I think that would be pretty awesome. Oh, I'm getting nailed. Man, Beaconator, I took out his long-range bot, and he's come back for revenge, and I almost took him out twice. So, now this is fun. I've been trying out some different Scourge options the past week. I only have two Scourges, so I'm kind of limited. I've been trying the Rog, which I like, the Doc. And the problem with the Rog is it just doesn't have a ton of firepower because you got to get close with the Scourges. So a couple other guys suggested, put it on the Griffin. And yeah, Magnums would work, but that's a little close range. Try the Geckos. The Geckos do some good firepower. Plus, they've got some range to match with the Scourges. So I tried it here the last couple matches, and I'm starting to get used to it. I think it's a pretty good deterrent for other Griffins. You stay out of their range, out of 300, 350, 500 range with this puppy. You get to hit them early with the Geckos, and then you get to hit them with the Scourges. And if they're not a mid-range, you can get closer in for more damage. So, Sara Soup, what bot would you run medium Scourges on? Think of all the bots.
I don't really know.
Like, say, you could do a Rog, a Doc. You could do a Dashbot Mark 1, 2, and 3. You could do a Lancelot, Fujin, Boa, Golem, anything with a medium slot on there. So, it's been kind of tough trying to figure out the best options. But I think the Griffin's got some potential with this guy. He's got the jump to get in and out of danger and to get closer in range, but then look what happened, guys. I jumped right into the center and an Ancelot. So we had to deal with that. Now, all you Rhino lovers out there, I decided to take my Rog out, and I still want speed, so I put the Rhino in with the full Orc and Pinata spread, and I love taking out Ancelots with this thing because you can run right inside their shield, and if they're plasma, you can put up your shield and block them and start whittling down their shield with your pinatas. So you got a lot of options. Plus, you can block long range snipers. Have y'all driven the Rhino kids on the test server?
Not
yeah,
me.
I did.
So Bags of Riches, you're our youngest guy, 5.5 years old. How hard is it for you to run the
Well I was stuck.
You got stuck? It's real hard. It's not the easiest bot in the world to pilot. Man, we are down on beacons.
I got stuck in this map somewhere.
On this map somewhere. What about you, Kiddos?
Well, I ran it one time. Just one time on this map. Just with Matthew when he was running it.
Yeah, it's kind of a tough one to use. It used to be the best, one of the best bots in the game at champion level. It was kind of like the Ancelot. Everybody was running it. And then, of course, the Griffin became dominant, and the Ancelot and the Lancelot. But now the Rhino speed sure helped. Now, I just got stuck, and this was a weird guy I was facing. He had plasma and rockets, so I kind of wasn't sure what to do. But I took out a couple of bots, two or three bots, before I went down. So I left Beacon Rush mode because it was just getting a little too crazy, and all week long or more I've been playing in Domination mode. Well, that means I can bring a little more range back in, and I really love the Lance Tempest. You can tell that we're defending home against three or four Ancelots here, and the Lance now has the accelerated rate of fire and does double damage to shields. So the accelerated rate of fire is helping to take the Ancel shield down, and the double damage to physical shields is helping to take that down. So right here I'm able to help with my team be able to block these guys' plasma and be able to take down two different Ancelots to hold off their rush towards our beacon here, because we're finally coming back in this match after being down. So who else here likes the Tempest? What would you run it on? Bags, what about you?
Raijin.
You love the Raijin? And the Tempest is pretty awesome. You like to climb up on things?
Yeah, like I climbed on something on power plant, and I nailed some bits, then someone killed me, and then I came out for revenge and I destroyed them.
You got revenge after they killed your Raijin Tempest?
Yeah.
What about you, Kiddos?
Well, I would run it on a shoot.
You'd run a Tempest on a shoot. Okay.
But Now that there's like bug of them being invisible,
we're on a test server.
Yeah, but now I just going to run it on the land.
Yeah, he wanted to run. Kiddos saying he wanted to run the Tempest shoots when the shoots was invincible on the test server a few weekends ago, but now that it's not invincible, what would you run it on, a lance?
Well, when it was not, I wanted to, but now it is. I want to do the Lance.
Yeah. Well, the Lance is awesome. It blocks plasma and sniper fire and does big damage at range. So, man, we did great in that match. Check it out, guys and girls. Did a million damage there and had some fun with the different setups. With the Dash Mark II plus the Griffin Scourge Geckos was a fun combo. Plus bringing the Rhino back out. He helped us recap some beacons. And finally, the Lancelot with the Molots really helped to take down some of those other Ancelots out there. That's a good Ancelot deterrent on a lot of maps. As long as they have Terrans, you can hold them off pretty decently. So we were looking at the competition and what they were running there. Their top guy on the red team. And then, of course, here was Beaconator starting out with his long range. But he's a tough cookie when he's using his regular range bots there. And then finally, we'll look back at our hangar and the kind of hybrid stuff we're running. I will be putting out a video later this week on the Dash Mark II and different setups and what works best. And then, of course, we're also going to be putting out a video on the Scourge with two or three Scourges, what setups are great. And then finally, you can see the rest of our hangar messing around with the Rhino and the Fujin and the Lancelot Molot. So, guys, I think that's it. That was a pretty good showdown there on Shenzhen. Let's say bye to everybody and hope they will click like if they like the video and leave a comment about the some of the things we talked about and go from there. All right, guys, let's say bye.
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 Bye. I love you guys.
Bye. I love you.
Man, that's a lot of love going on in this room. Well, guys and girls, we hope you enjoyed the video. We had a little showdown on Shenzhen. And once again, we hope you have a great War Robots Day.